this morning. We're already noticing widespread rain over top of the area. As we're looking a little bit, we do see a little bit of some freezing rain trying to work into the mix. We are having surface temperatures actually above freezing, but we could see those temperatures try to glide on down. That's why this winter weather advisory is issued for Greenbrier, Monroe, and Giles County, all for the potential of freezing rain. Could have a little bit of some trace ice accumulation in the area throughout this morning. This has actually just updated, if you just noticed. They took off western Greenbrier and just added eastern Greenbrier County, but still, there is that potential. Could have a little bit of some ice accumulation if those temperatures do get below freezing for the area, but we are noticing now nowhere is actually seen below that freezing mark or even at the freezing mark. Most of us are into the 30s. We do have the lower 40s and even the middle 40s right now, 46 in Pineville and 47 in Grundy to start off the day. Most of us are only going to have those temperatures heading into that 40 degree threshold. We're going to keep up with these widespread showers throughout the entirety of the day. Windy conditions too. We're already seeing wind gusts picking up to 20 miles per hour for a few spots. Throughout the afternoon this evening, we could see a few areas picking up to 40 miles per hour, even higher throughout today. That's why we have wind advisories issued for eastern Fayette and the western and northern portions of Pocahontas County. This advisory is going to continue until 10 p.m. tonight, starting at 8 a.m. though. Now for western Greenbrier, Summers, Mercer, Bland, Wythe, and Tazewell counties, this advisory is already active and will continue until 6 p.m. this evening. So winds are going to continue to be over top of the area, really gusting in force as we head into the afternoon. Good southeasterly flow over the area. As we head into tonight, though, we will start to see winds calm down just a little bit. Could still have gusts picking up to about 10 to 15 miles per hour. And it's all because of the system right here why we're having the majority of rain showers over top of the area. We are going to have a few heavier downpours expected out sometimes today. Cooler air is back behind the system, though. This is going to slowly trickle into our area as we head into the overnight hours tonight and throughout Saturday and even into Monday. We could potentially still be holding on to a little bit of some snowfall. Main thing today is going to be the rain showers. We do have a potential for some heavier downpours over the area. Most of us should at least see about half an inch of rainfall. A few areas, especially east of I-77, will have a little bit more rain gear towards them. Could reach upwards to an inch. North of that I-64 corridor could see over an inch of rainfall. So a little bit of ponding on the roadways is possible today. And where we're having the windy conditions too, could see some power outages and some downed tree limbs. So throughout today, we'll be holding on to the majority of rain showers, very widespread over the area. Heavier downpours expected, especially as we head later afternoon and throughout this evening. We'll have a pretty impressive line try to come on through. Temperatures tonight are going to fall down into the 30s, just like what we're experiencing now. A few scattered showers possible tonight. Looks like a little bit more drier air is going to work its way into the area. Do see a potential as we head into tomorrow morning for this rain to transition into a little bit of some light snowfall. Very spotty showers, though. Most of us look relatively dry throughout the day tomorrow. And then into Sunday, we see a little bit more snow try to become a little bit better in coverage, but still very light in nature. Now here's a look at that snowfall forecast. Most of us only going to be seeing a trace to 1 inch as you head a little bit more up to the north, seeing 1 to 3 inches and even upwards to 2 to 4 inches. But most of us are just in that trace to 1 inch ballpark. We do have that cool pool of air that's going to arrive for us tomorrow, allowing that transition from rain into some very light snowfall.